Hello, and welcome to today's online intelligence briefing focusing on loitering munitions. Now, loitering munitions are a relatively unique family of weapon systems, as their capabilities and performance can overlap with standoff missiles and certain unmanned aerial vehicles. Janes categorizes loitering munitions under the precision guided weapons market. To classify a system as a loitering munition, they are expected to have the majority, if not all, of the following features. They are designed to be expendable single-use munitions. They can loiter over target areas for an extended period of time. They can vary their airspeed to ensure maximum efficiency during different phases of flight. They can conduct target search and acquisition within a selected target area. There can be a man in the loop, allowing for the aborting of an attack. And they have an integrated warhead or payload. Today, loitering munitions are available in a multitude of designs and sizes and are being used in several roles.
Loitering munitions can be seen in two broad categories: large munitions, which are platform mounted, and small or mini munitions for portable use. Within the large munition segment, capabilities are developed or being developed for all kinds of platforms, including ground, sea, and air. We have seen growing trend for integration on ground and maritime platforms, mainly unmanned systems. In addition, arming air platforms, particularly unmanned aerial vehicles, are also catching up with the rapid technological advancements. Within the small or mini weapons segment, compact designs with improved endurance and lethality can be seen across the board. Miniaturized sensors, growing automation capabilities have enabled many portable solutions to meet complex armed forces requirements. WB Group's Wormat is Poland's fully autonomous tactical loitering munition that can be equipped with various payloads, including fragmentation, heat, and thermobaric warheads. In 2019, WB Group unveiled two more variants, Wormat TL and Wormat V. It's a VTOL variant. Moreover, Wormat is being offered as an alternative to standard anti-tank missiles. Early this year, it was certified for the Polish Army. However, OEM is also pursuing the development of swarming technologies to meet armed forces needs, initially with network up to 6 Wormat munitions. This is a response to most of the challenges posed by electronic warfare. Success is also seen in export market by making inroads in Ukraine and unspecified NATO member nation. Next is Aerovenounments Switchblade 600. It is a tube-launched loitering munition and new member of the Switchblade family, which is designed to support anti-armor fire missions, even in contested environments where GPS can be denied by electronic warfare capabilities. Although it can be deployed from ground, sea, and air platforms, OEM continues the product improvement program. The US Army is prime customer, and it supports the project via multi-year contracts. Moreover, the US Special Operations Command plans to equip Switchblade on the developmental U.S. Naval Special Warfare Combat Craft. Early this year, United Kingdom joined the user club by ordering Switchblade loitering munitions, but variant is unknown. Developer is exploiting full potential of the weapon, such as integrate it on the unmanned ground vehicles. Next is the China's Poly Defense CH901. It is a tube-launched loitering munition which can be used from ground or air platforms. It also comes in a ISR version. The CH901 provides People's Liberation Army troops a tactical reconnaissance system that can also serve as a strike and battle damage assessment system. As part of future upgrades, developers plans to have swarming of loitering munition capability. This project is believed to act as a torchbearer for other competitive domestic programs. OEM is actively pursuing for export sales, and conventional users could be the immediate buyers, including Pakistan.